So in today's video, I'm going to try to attempt a challenge to see how I would have solved this on my own. One of the viewers asks about a custom post type of a course and says, can I make two post types that are related, one of course and another of lessons, and I could complicate it a little bit by adding modules. And there are two ways of looking at this, so let me go inside my WordPress. Now, WordPress offers us something that's called custom post types, and if I wasn't going to do something that's very complex in terms of something like a management system where you can use things like LangDash or Lifter LMS, I could simply go for a custom post type, and then maybe I would add in some custom taxonomies for me to do that. And what I mean simply is that, let's say if I come to posts here, posts are posts, but you could make your own post, and which is a custom post type. And you could have taxonomies where you have something like these categories right here. So let me try to jump into code so that I can show you what I exactly mean. So inside my root folder of my website, I'm going to go to WP Content, I'll go into the plugins, and inside here I'm going to create a new folder which I'll call custom LMS. And I'm going to drag and drop this into my editor, and inside my editor I'll start by adding the custom-lms file, and this is a .php because we're going to write it for WordPress, and WordPress mainly works with PHP on the server side. I'll start with PHP here, and then I'll start off with a MyStart plugin. This is a code snippet I always add when I want to start plugins. A license, I'll give it a GPL, I'll give it a custom plugin name, and I'll call it a custom LMS. And then I'll change the links, put in my domain, I'll plugin author, I'll just put my brand name here, and then I'll say custom LMS or simple custom LMS. Simple custom LMS, I'll just change the name of this right here as well. And then everything else here will just be simple custom dash LMS. Now, first thing is I'll add some simple security by saying is defined. We're going to find out if the app's path is actually defined. And this can only be found inside WordPress. And if someone tries to access this particular file of yours by hitting, let's say, the domain URL and try to get to this file to run its code, it will not allow them. So you're simply saying that decision needs to come from WordPress to run this plugin and not from an outside call. That will help us get to this level. Now the first thing I'm going to do is add a custom post type, and the custom post type I'm going to be adding is for courses, so it's called courses. Now inside here I'll add a custom taxonomy. I'll add a custom taxonomy called module. And then finally inside those individual posts as well, create the different lessons. So this is quite easy. I'll just come here and Google this. And so I'll say custom post type, say custom post type, WordPress codex. And you'll see we have this function of register post type that we have to use. Now let me go and just pick the sample code. And we have this method of WordPress which is called register post type, where we pass in the post type and a couple of array items. Now these parameters that go in the array are the labels, the public, the description, making it hierarchical, we can exclude from search, we can make it publicly queryable, we can show it in the UI, in the menu, and all these other things, and even showing it in the REST API right here. That will allow us to use things like Gutenberg if we want to. And then just adding capability. Do we want this to only be for the administrators, or should subscribers and other people be seeing this? So there are so many options that you can choose from here to write your custom post type. But what I'm going to do here on this page is scroll all the way down so that I can see just a sample usage of this particular post type. So I'll copy this code. It's among one of the highly recognized comments, come back here in my code and I'll paste it. Then I'll just run through for you what's going on. So on the add action, we are using the init hook so that when WordPress is initialized, we run this function that actually starts from here. Now, remember we talked about having the register post type function running here. So in here, we're running a post type of recipe, which I am going to change for all these different times it appears. I'm going to change the word recipe and I'm going to call that course so that I'm registering a number of courses. And then in the arguments, I'm going to pass in this number of arguments. So I pass in the labels, which labels is also a value that we've stated here. So we have that name, the name of the courses, which is courses. We have the singular name for course. The menu name will be courses. We'll add it to the admin bar to add course. We'll add the add new item, editing, and all the different things down here that we need. So I'll save this, come back to my admin side, I'll reload here, and you'll see that our plugin is available, and then I'll click activate. When I activate it, you'll see that we have here courses showing up, and we are able to add a new course if we want to. So I'm going to call this English. So I'll call this course English. Now the reason I can use it in Gutenberg is because I added it to show in REST. Now if I want to use only the old editor or the classic editor on this, I need to show in REST as false instead of true. So I'll save this as false, come back here, reload, and you're going to see that we have the old editor just showing up because we've denied it to be shown in REST, and that's the way Gutenberg works. It works with the REST API. So I'll go back to my code here, and I'm only going to support, let's say, the editor, the author. I'll allow a thumbnail so that we can have a picture at the end of the day. So there are these options that you have to look into, and we usually get the basic of this. So it's not hierarchical. We're giving it a position of 20, we're giving it supports, and we're going to create our own custom taxonomy. So I'm going to remove this category and post tag, and we shall create our own custom taxonomy showing up here. So you see right here, we're having categories showing up. So when I reload here, we don't have categories showing up anymore. So we're going to create our own category, which we shall call modules. So I can come back here and then scroll all the way to up. I just need to find the search, and I'm going to say, look for custom taxonomy. Hit enter. And you will see that we also have another function called register taxonomy. Now, when we register the taxonomy here, it will ask for the taxonomy name, and then we'll have other arguments that we pass in. For example, we want to have an object type, we want it to be of an array, or do we want it to just be a string? Then we add particular variables like the label, the description, should it be publicly queryable, should we show it in the UI, should we show it in the REST? We are doing all these things and adding them, so I'll just scroll again down, and then we're going to look for an implementation like what we have here, and this is sort of going to help. So I'm going to copy this, come here and paste it, and we have two taxonomies that are being registered. So what I'm going to do is just remove one of these. So we use the init hook again of WordPress to run this function, and we give it a priority of 0 so that it fires really early. Now when we come to the function that we are calling right here in the hook, we see that we have labels, and these labels are name, like genre, singular is genre, we add text for when it's going to be searched, and all of these things. And then we add a menu name, and then we add whether it should be hierarchical, we add whether it should have labels, should it show in the UI, should we have an admin column for this. should we rewrite it? And we are going to rewrite it with a slug of genre. But I don't want to have this as genre. Remember, we said we're going to have module in its place. So I'll change this to module. But we want this to show in a particular post type. And the post type we want this to show up in is actually the post type that we made here. So the post type we want to have here is course. So I'll copy what we have here as course and change it for book. So we have registered a new module. We want it to be part of the course, and we've run its different arguments. So let me save this, come back to our backend. I'm going to reload here, and you'll see that we have modules showing up here. Now, of course, we can change this. It's not looking so nice in our menu, and we're going to call it course module. I'll change this to uppercase, and I'll change all these other ones. Module right here. Change this to uppercase so that we have it proper and looking nice. I'll save this, come back here, reload, and you'll see that we have course module here. And when I click on it, I am now able to add new modules. For example, I can say our course is going to be English, and the module I'm talking about is comprehension. So that's the module we work. I'll save this as a module. I'll come back to my courses here, and I'm going to go into the English course, and you're going to see that we have a module showing up right here. So when I click on this and hit update, you're going to see that I can classify this particular course with its module, and that's as far deep as possible as I can go. I cannot write individual lessons to it, but we can look at this in the reverse. So let's say if I created another taxonomy, and that taxonomy I am going to call it courses, and then I'll change my post type to be a lesson. So we are sort of reversing the outlook of everything. So let me go back into our code. We're going to change this course into lesson, and then we're going to change our custom post type from courses to lesson. So let me look for course. I'm going to change that to lesson. We'll allow modules to be in there, and then I'm going to also duplicate the same thing here. I'll have to unset labels because I've used it up and I don't want it to become a problem again down here. I'll also unset the args because I'm using it down here again, so args. So I'll unset those two. In the second place where we're using module, I'll change this to course, make this lowercase c, save this, come back here, I'll reload, and we're going to see that this is broken because we no longer have that post type. And I'll hit my dashboard here, and you're going to see we have lessons, and inside lessons we have lesson module and we have lesson course. Now, whenever we add a new lesson, let's say we're going to call this lesson one, we can add a module. It's going to be in comprehension, and the course is going to be English. So when we save this, we can be able to query this by course, then by module, and then by lesson. So we can query this on the front end or on the REST API coming from it backwards. So we start from course and say, let's get all the courses coming in, let's get all the modules, and then let's get all the lessons that are as per each individual taxonomy. There's another way of doing this, and that's by using a plugin called Advanced Custom Field. Now, Advanced Custom Fields, written by Elliot Condon, is one of the most powerful plugins there are, and it has over 1 million installs. I'm going to just install it, and I'm going to show you a couple of things about it that are just really, really advanced and super. So I'll activate the plugin now, and once I have it in here, I'm going to deactivate the simple custom LMS for now. Let's see what's happening in here. So we have a new menu item here, which is called custom fields, and in here we can add a new field. And this field can be called custom LMS fields. Now, it can be tied to a particular post type if that's what you want to do, to have that. And what we're going to do is we are going to go back to our custom LMS plugin and we are going to do something different for now. So I'm going to go back to my plugins still. I'll activate custom simple LMS, and instead of lessons in here, I'm going to comment out everything and just create new posts. So I'll copy this code that helps us to make new posts, and I'm going to comment out everything else. So save this. So there's no code that's active. I'm just going to create some new post types. And for example, this post type that I have here of lessons, I'll have that, which is okay. I'm going to create another post type. I'll need to change this name, and then I'll call this create modules CPT. I'm also going to change what we have here, and I'm going to create some other CPT or a custom post type, which I'll just go for this. Let me change this from modules CPT, look for the one down, make sure I'm changing this and calling this lessons CPT. So I'll save this, come back and change what I need to change here. So we have this CPT right here, which we are going to call courses, create underscore courses CPT. So I'll change this lessons into courses. I'll change every instance that we have here of lesson. So we're going to have the first one, and it's going to be courses. Courses, which is okay. The next one that we'll have is going to be modules. So we need to change this lesson into modules. So we have our courses up here. We need to change this. So we have our courses up here. We then have down here modules. And then after that, we have our lessons here. So let me save this. Come back to the admin area, reload. And you're going to see we have courses, we have modules, we have lessons. These are all different items that we can use. Now, in the individual custom fields, I'm going to just publish this. And then so that we can be able to now see our new modules, courses, and lessons showing up here. So I'm going to tie particular fields to the individual post types, okay? So in the post type of our lessons, I'm going to add a couple of fields. So in here we can have the teacher's name, and we have that, that will be a text, it will be required, update that. And when we go back to our lessons, so I'm going to come to lessons, and when you look at lesson one, it already has teachers right here. So what I'm going to do is try to attach the different modules and courses into this lesson. So I'll go back to the fields, I'm going to go back to custom fields, click edit, and I'm going to add the connection between the module and the different lessons. So in here, the field that I want is going to be relational, and it's going to be a relationship. So in this relationship, I want it to be required, and I want it to be filtered by one particular post type, and which is modules. So I'll allow the filters of such post type and a taxonomy, so I don't need taxonomy. I'll remove the post type because it's only going to be for one post type, which is modules. So what I'll do here is finish this all up and hit update. Now when I come back to one lesson, go back to the lesson here, you will see that we have teachers, and then we can set this in a particular module. Now the reason this is empty is because we don't have modules as yet. So let me create some dummy modules. I'll create this as comprehension. Click publish. Add a new one, I'll call this a composition, publish, And then I'll also come to courses, and I'm going to get a new course which I'll call English. So click save. Now, whenever we're making lessons here, we can come to our lesson, we add the teacher. The teacher is going to be TechiePress. And then we can add the module, and our module is going to be composition. We can also add comprehension if we want, but we don't want this to be part of both modules. So I'll just leave on the one module here. So I'll click this minus to remove that. And then the other thing that I want to do is add a particular course to this. So I'll hit update here so that we don't lose that data. I'll come back to my fields, come back to this, and then I'm going to create a course so that we know each lesson is attached to a module, and that module is probably attached to a course, or I can do the reverse. So course, and I'll say course is that, it's going to be relational in nature, it's going to be a relationship. I'll require it, and the post type this should go is to courses. I'll remove the taxonomy because I don't need that, and the post type, and I'm going to come here and update. So when we go back to our lessons here and get our lesson one, we can attach our lesson one to the composition module, and we can attach it to the English module. So when I save this, I can be able to query the different lessons and then categorize them basing on the different fields that I've added here. So we can now query for this lesson, and we are sure that it will have the module and it will have the course added to it. So this is how I would probably do it to ensure that it's working fine using a plugin like Advanced Custom Fields to determine that all my points of information are actually showing up compared to using a taxonomy. And the reason is SEF would allow me to add boxes like this of information to each individual post type. So with courses, I can add different details of metadata, just like with the modules and just like with the lessons itself here. So with even with this lesson, I can add a field. So if I come back here to fields and then go to, I want to edit this LMS field. So I'm going to change this to lesson fields, so that it's very clear. I'm going to add a field here which I'm going to call document. So maybe this document is something that I want to upload work. So I want to upload a document, so I can come here, choose a different type, and in here I want to have upload, and I'll choose file here so that it will allow me to upload a file. And what I want to do is return a file URL, not just an array. Maybe I want to get the array or file URL, whatever it is, and I'll add it to upload it to post. And then I can add here limit for the file sizes, minimum to 0 and then maximum to 300 MB. And then I'll come update this document. And when I come back to my lessons here, I'm able to look down all the way and I can add a document from anywhere, my computer or wherever, and it is working fine. So this would be a better option for me to just use SCF to create my own learning management system and give it the different fields that I need to do that.